Hello everyone, my name is Greg and I dev stuff. Welcome everyone to episode 30 of Stardew Valley-like game in Unity. In this episode we will implement character stats and status bar for them. This episode is brought to you by generous support of people on Patreon. If you want to join them, link to my Patreon in the description. Open the character script. In this script, we will be describing and storing all the relevant information about the character. So first, let's create a class called Stat from Statistics. This class will be responsible for storing stats like HP or Stamina, one which can have current and max value. Declare two public integer variables for max and current value. Create a constructor for them. So create two public stats in the character. One for HP and one for Stamina. To make them editable in our inspector, mark the class as serializable. Good. Now let's go back to our character script. We want to describe the process of taking damage and checking if our character is dead or not. Create new public bool variable called isDead. Now let's declare a new method called takeDamage with the amount as a parameter. And it will create and call a new method inside this stat called subtract. This method will decrease the current value by the past parameter. Check if the HP current value is below 0, set the isDead bool to be true. Let's create a new method called heal, which will restore the HP by amount passed as a parameter. Similar to the subtract, generate a new method inside the stats called add. In the new add method, add the past parameter to the char value. But what if your HP goes over the max value? We should check for this, and in case it does, set it to be the same as max value. Now we will mirror this for stamina. Make get tired, which will subtract the amount from stamina. Rest, which will restore some amount of stamina. And full rest, which will restore the stamina to the max. Add is exhausted bool variable. And in the get tired, check it if the current value of stamina is lower than 0, then we're exhausted. Good. Now we have all parameters set. We want to create a health bar and stamina bar for our character. Create a new panel called Character Status Panel, and let's inside create an image for background and image for the bar. Put a marker sprite into the image and set the bar to be filled image type. This will allow us to assign field state for the bar. Change it to be horizontal. Create a prefab for the bar. Good. Create an instance for stamina. Because how we are going to design this bar, we will be able to reuse it for all kinds of systems. For HP, stamina, skill bars, XP bars, progress bars, whatever. Absolutely anything which works on some kind of range and need to be tracked. Inside, let's create numbers so we can show the state of the character in the numerical way. We want to apply the new text, but we don't want to override the color of the HP bar. To partially apply the changes to prefab, select the desired change you want to apply and click apply. Good. Now our HP bar has numbers too. This text number I input is just for the show. You don't have to do this. It's just so we have some kind of base representation of what will come out in the end. Create another new component called status bar. Let's apply it to so both of the bars will have the script. Open the newly created script. Let's create a reference to the text and the image for the bar. Assign those references in the editor. Actually, make the bar fill the whole background. Instead of directly changing the image, fill amount, we will use slider component. Make sure that your bar is anchored to fill the container. Look at the anchors. They are right now in the middle. We want them to fill the bar. Simply click here and select this. Add component called slider to the main object. And set the fill to the bar inside. Good. Turn off transition and interactable. We don't need them. Time to apply all the changes. Fix the color. Oh, and we're going to use whole numbers, so set the whole numbers to true. Replace image with slider reference. Now create a new public method called set, where we will pass our car and max value. And set them to slider. Max value and just value. Where max is max value and value is car. Then assign the text to the text object. Now we need to call and pass values to this method from our character. So create two references for the status bars. And call set on the start. Assign references in the editor. And let's assign some values to the HP and stamina. Good. Now let's make the update of the parse its own method. And call it every time we change the state of the character. So if you take damage, call the update HP bar. And if you get tired, call update stamina bar. You know, when any of the bars need to be updated, we call them. Let's make a small test. I will assign take damage, heal, get tired, and rest to the numbers on the keyboard. And let's check, does our HP and stamina works? Yes, it does. Good. It even recognizes that I'm dead or exhausted by changing the state of the bool. Right now this bool variable bear no mechanical state in our game. It's just there, but soon we will introduce it into our game. Good, this is it for this episode. If you have any questions or any ideas about code, please leave your comment below. If you are interested in seeing what will come out of this, please subscribe. If you want to support further, you can find my Patreon in the description. Special thank you to Cameron Smith for his generous support.